when it comes together, you can get them like this. I don't care where you fish, Mississippi, Tennessee, Oklahoma, or Ontario. Crappie that big and black are just beautiful. Are you in here? Are you? I'll lower this down a bit. Tighten up my float. Put it amongst these little clumps here. Nothing looking water. Spawning water. Are you in here? Just isolated clumps. Not thick stuff, but it's the same stuff you find in those little canals and little back bays that most guys run to. But in this case, it's out in the bay. So potentially, you could have it almost all to yourself. Fish? Oh yeah. Look at this. You see? Outside edges. Wow. And look at that. That's what I'm looking for right there. That's what I mean. Whoa, see? Whoa. Where are you going, Bubba? Huh? See? Hold on, you. You see? Sometimes they're not always in the canals and stuff. And had a little bit of a rain delay. Stay away, rain, please. And I have to find a little pocket, a little hole. I'm gonna stay back a little bit, cast these fish. I've just seen some clumps here. That's the result. Oh, I'm gonna keep at it, see if I can get some real big guys to go with that guy. But that's a nice little start. Look at him. That's the kind of crappie I'm talking about, right here, right there. Get in there, boy. You've gotta move around, be versatile, adapt. If it rains, bring your rain suit. If it's not going in the spots you want, the fish are spooky, or you know there's cloud cover and they're just not biting the way you want, or they're not the size you want, move around because you're going to catch them if you do that. I see more clumps over here, but I need that sun to come back out. You know, weather plays a big part, man, in fishing, no matter what you're fishing for. But crappie, they can get so spooky. Angling pressure, spawning mood, whatever it is. You move around and find them. Like I say, potentially you could have it all to yourself. You still gotta be patient. I'm only in about 2.5 feet of water, 3 feet maybe. But it's the clumps are the key. That's the stuff they spawn on. I vary the float. Now you think, wow, it looks really shallow in here. It is, but it's deceiving. Especially clear water. Like, look at that. What's that, 18 inches or so? I got the little slip float, little tutti frutti tube. It's all torn apart from those ones this morning. And a couple sinkers on there just for the weight, so the float will stand up. So I make longer casts too. Stay back from them, let it sit. You just hope they turn right on. Because most times, as soon as that thing lands, boom, another one comes over, eats it. There's one. How big are you? Oh, another slab. Look at these things. Holy cow. I gotta have to get that little net. Look at this thing. Wow. There's my crappy net. And there's the results. Again. Wow, eh? When you stay back, find another location that's got them. And I tell you, when it comes together, you can get them like this. I don't care where you fish, Mississippi, Tennessee, Oklahoma, or Ontario. Crappie that big and black are just beautiful. We're gonna take a few for dinner, let some big ones go for pictures. But in the meantime, I don't wanna put them back or any other ones and potentially spook them. Does it really happen? I don't know. But you know what? If it's in my mind, I don't wanna be thinking about that. So we'll take them for a little swim. They're just decent sized to eat too, beautiful. Oh, nice dark colors. Go join your friend. I love it. But the thing is, I'm gonna stay in shallow water. Shallow, 1 to 3 feet. If they're trying to do their business, they'll be either underneath docks, near wood, clumps, anything that they can hold to that's a little bit warmer. Patience is gonna be the virtue today. Taking my time, just like chasing the big bass or big walleyes, muskie, whatever it is. Take your time for those bigger fish. Where are you, slabs? Where are you? There we go. Oh yeah, big slab. Big slab. Look at him. Oh boy. Look at him. Splishing and splashing. No giant, but just solid. Solid, solid, solid. Man, oh man, gotta stay back and take my time. Look where he's got that. Oh, you couldn't get any closer than that, could you? Look how soft it came out. That's why I use really sharp little hooks, man. There's all kinds on the market. But the sharp ones, Daiichi, X-Point, he's neat in size, wouldn't you think? Aren't you? You are. You know what? I catch quite a bit of fish all year long. Blessed to, obviously. Very blessed. But you know what? When I get a few like that to eat, I'll do that. Because, man, they taste good. Go in there and join your buddies. I'm just grateful that the rain stopped. Had to slow down a bit, but you know what? I want to catch some big fish, some big crappie. Got a few under the docks, nothing real big. Moved around, had a bit of a break after the rain, but just taking time. I'm looking for a few more cuts, maybe some more wood, but this shallow clumps where they should be doing their business is where they're at. You see about options. Sometimes you got to change it up and stuff. You know what? I got the 5'6", 6 foot, and 6'6" with the floats. Little slip float. You know, you just vary the bobber stop, how deep you want it. And just keep changing it, depending on the depth you are. When I was fishing under the docks and stuff, I was pretty high up. And one of those fishes would come out and just dart at it. When I came in, there's little cuts on the shorelines and little bays. I vary it back and forth. Got a couple of fish in about 3.5 feet. So just vary the depth. Fish. Good one too. Oh boy. Big slab, big slab. Look at that. Oh boy, he's an alligator. Look at him. Look at that thing go, hey? How's that for a slabrosaurus, huh? Yeah, man. Oh. Although they're taking it, they sure ain't gobbling it. But that, look at the back on him. Look at how thick that is. Gorgeous little fish, isn't it? Gorgeous, look at him. More than a hand size, look at him. Big fins, big mouth. Just perfect size, man. The big ones, that's what I wanted to come for. That's what I'm catching now. And I feel good. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na. I feel good. Dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. Go join your friends, boy. Got a small limit. Good dinner, a few pictures. That's when the big ones go. Let's keep going. Sometimes you just got to stick it out. Get out in those little spots, you know, go to the docks, you see the crappie, you catch your crappie, get frustrated, move around. If it rains, have your stuff ready, but stick it out. Go out, have a good time. Have your rods rigged, and then you can get them like that at the end of the day. Makes it all worthwhile when you find those big, fat slabs. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time, right here. Slab Heaven.